All right, we have another vocab, two back to back. Number 24, the problem with those answer choices was that all of the words seemed a little too slangy, a little too informal for the situation. Here we're gonna have almost the opposite problem. Let's take a look at these. It says, because a traditionalist response to the crisis, which is amping up medical college enrollments and expanding physician training programs, is too slow and costly to address the near-term problem, alternatives are being explored. So the main piece I'm focusing on is here. What they're trying to say is something like increasing medical college enrollments and expanding physician training programs. We could even steal the word expanding, right? We're looking for a word that means increasing or expanding. It's in the sentence. They're really strongly hinting that that's what we want. All of these words kind of mean that, but they all fall in different places on our spectrum of word tone. So slangy, academic, and pedantic, which of course is a fancy word that means you've chosen words that are too fancy. So hopefully you've been exposed to enough commercials for energy drinks that you know that amping up is very slangy. That's like, yeah, you just took a Red Bull and you're all amped up on caffeine. Like, that's not what we're talking about. You don't amp up people in college, at least not the way they're talking about here. So that doesn't work. Revving up is very similar. Revving is, you know, a car engine. You rev an engine and it makes that sound. So that also doesn't really work for just increasing numbers. Arousing. Well, that word maybe is academic enough, but hopefully you associate that word with like sex ed, right? Arousing has to do with, you know, arousing different body parts. So that's not a good fit for this situation. That means we have to pick this word bolstering, and many of you might not know what that word means. But this is a good example where just because a word is hard does not mean that it's always wrong. If we know that the other three words don't fit, we have to pick the hard word. So that's kind of the situation here for most people, is they hopefully know that these three other words just don't fit with this situation. So they're not afraid to pick the hard word because they're like, well, that's all that's left. Now, that solves the problem for this particular question. But to make a larger point, bolster is an important word. You should really know this for the SAT, for college. This is a good word. To bolster means to support or improve or, in this case, increase. It's just a good word to know. I put it in the pedantic column because I think that that's how most of you probably see this word right now. But I'd love to shift it into the academic for you. This is a good word that comes up a lot in kind of like newspapers and more academic writing. It's a good word to use in your own papers. So look out for it. See if you can start seeing it in other places. Look up the definition. Try to see it in a couple of sentences. It's a good word to know. And obviously, if you had known it, this would have been a really easy question because it's a perfect fit for this situation. So bolster your scores by looking up the word bolster.